Hey guys, today we're going over how to construct tangent segments along a curve, and we're also going to look at how to create an animation showing tangent lines sequentially generated using a slider. Here we are in GeoGebra. For this demo, I'm going to be using a parabola given by f of x equals 1/2 x squared, but feel free to use any function you want. Okay, so let's go ahead and type in our function. Okay, so what I want to do next is parameterize our function. So how do we do that? Well, in general, if we need to parameterize a function of the form y equals f of x, we can set x equal to t and y equal to f of t. For our case, we will parameterize our parabola using x equals t and y equals 1/2 t squared. In my previous video, I mentioned that we can plot parametric curves using the curve command, and that's what we're going to use right now. So let's go ahead and type in curve, and we'll go with the first option. And for our first expression, that's for x, so that's going to be t. For our second expression, we could type 1/2 t squared. That's fine. I'm going to go ahead and use f of t instead, since we already have our function. Okay, our parameter variable is t. Our starting value is -5, and our ending value is 5. Let's move this down a little bit, and I'm going to disable our original function. The next thing we're going to do is create a sequence of parameter values with the goal of generating points along the parametric curve. And we can do so using the sequence command. Let me expand this a little bit. Let's go ahead and type in sequence. And I'm going to go with the third option here, which requires a starting value, ending value, and an increment. So I'm going to type in -5 and 5. That matches our parameter interval over here. And I'm going to use an increment value of 0.5 for now. Notice that the sequence command returns a list of values. We can access elements of this list by using the name of the list. And by the way, before I do anything else, let me change this to, let me call this tvals. Okay, so if I want to access an element from this list, I can type in tvals. And let's say I want to access the second element. That returns -4.5. Let's do another one. Let's do tvals of the fifth element, and we get -3. You can also use the element command in GeoGebra, so that's element. And let's go with the first template, and we can provide the name of the list. That's tvals. And let's say we use the fifth element, and notice that that matches our output from our previous command. Oftentimes, you'll also want to know how many elements are in a list, so we can use the length command. So let's type in length, and let's type in tvals. And currently there are 21 elements in this list. Okay, so now that we have our list of parameter values, we can take this set of values and provide them as input for our parametric equation by typing a, evaluated at tvals. And this returns a list of points that correspond to the parameter values, and we can also see that these points have been plotted along the curve. Great. So now that we have our list of points, what we want to do next is place tangent lines at each of these points. What's great about the sequence command is that you're not limited to creating a sequence of numbers. You can also use the sequence command to create lists of other objects, such as tangent lines, rectangles, and so forth. Let's go ahead and change this name to points. Type in sequence. This time I'm going to use the last template. Okay, so for our expression, we're going to use the tangent command, and let's go with the third one. And this requires a point on the curve and then a curve. Now, we already talked about how to access elements from a list, and so here I want to access the ith point from our points list. So we can type in points, and then I'm going to use I. Our original curve is A. My index variable is I. My starting value is going to be 1. The ending value will be the length of our points list, and we'll go ahead and use an increment of 1. All right, so now we can see that tangents have been placed at each point on the curve. For the next part, I'm going to create a slider that goes from 1 up to the length of our list. Here we can use the points list or even the tvals list. They both have the same number of elements, so it doesn't matter. So I'm going to create a slider called n. Let's type in slider. And my minimum value is going to be 1. My maximum value will be the length of one of these lists. I'm going to go with the points list. The increment will be 1, and let's set the speed to 2. And I don't need the rest of these parameters, so I'm going to erase these. Let's press enter. The slider is going to be used for an animation that sequentially generates tangent lines along the parabola. To do this, we're going to use a take command. If we look at the GeoGebra documentation for this command, it says that it returns a list containing elements from the start position to the end position of the initial list. So let's see how this works by typing take. And let's go with the first option here. For the first parameter, I'm going to provide the list of tangent lines, and that's given by L1. That's where our tangent lines are stored. Our starting position is going to be 1, and our ending position is going to be the slider value. So that's going to be N. Let's press enter. Okay, so what I'm going to do next is disable our tangent lines here. And let me remove this. Okay, so let's run our animation. Let's speed it up a little bit. Okay, so right now it's in oscillation mode. Let me set the slider to increasing. So if we go to settings and go to slider, let's change it from oscillating to increasing. Let's click out of that. Let's run the animation again. All right, looks good. So here what the take command is doing is taking a subset from our original list of tangent lines given by L1. And we know this by moving the slider. So let's say we move it to 1. And currently it's showing just a single tangent line. That's our first tangent line. If we move it to, let's say, 3, now it shows 3 tangent lines. Now, I don't want this to show the first tangent line that corresponds to a slider value of n equals 1. We can remove the tangent line by simply setting our initial slider value to n equals 0 instead of n equals 1. So let's do that. Let's change this to 0. Let's move it down. And now it's gone. And that's perfectly fine because if we look at the output here, we simply have an empty list when n is equal to 1. Okay, let's run our animation. Now, let's go back to our tvals list and let's see. Let's decrease this value of 0.5 to, let's say, 0.2. And let's go ahead and run the animation again. Oh, there's an issue right here. Let's adjust this. Let's change it to, let's change it to length of list 1. Okay, there we go. Before it was 21, now it's 51. So let's go ahead and start it again. All right, that's exactly what I want. Perfect. If you want, we can also use the take command to generate the points. All we have to do is duplicate this take command that we have here for the tangent lines. And we need to change the list to our points list. Press enter. And we also need to disable our original list. And let's go ahead and run the animation. And now we can see that it's not just the tangent lines being generated, it's also the points being generated. All right, let me stop this. I think that will do it for this portion of the video. Now, let's look into how we can create a sequence of tangent segments at each point on the parabola. Before we do that, let's briefly go over how to do this with a single tangent segment at a point on the parabola. So here I started a new GeoGebra session. I went ahead and reproduced some of the commands from the previous GeoGebra session. Okay, so let's go ahead and place a point on the curve at 2, 2. So I'm gonna type 2, f evaluated at 2. And so we have a point A right here. I also wanna place a tangent line there. So I'm gonna type in tangent. And we'll do point A on curve A. What I'm going to introduce next is the direction command, which, as the name implies, gives the direction of a line. So let's type in direction. And here I'm going to provide the tangent line. And I'm actually going to label this as V. And so here we have a vector in standard position that gives the direction of the tangent line. And we know this because the vector is parallel to the tangent line. Let's go ahead and zoom in a little bit. And let's move it. Okay. Now let's see what happens when we add the vector to the point A. So we'll type A plus V. Let's press enter. And so what's happening here is that the point A was translated by the vector V. The translate command accomplishes the same thing. So we can type in translate, press enter. Let's go with the first option, which requires an object and then the vector. We can type in A and then the vector V. And let's change this color to red. All right, so we can see that the point overlaps with our other point. So we can disable A and then B, A. There we go. By the way, if you want, you can even translate the curve. So if we type in translate and then type in our object, which is the parametric curve, and then the vector, it'll move the curve to a different position. Let me erase that. So to gain a better understanding of what's going on here, we can use a slider. So let's create a slider that goes from negative 2 to 2. So I'm going to call it n, slider. And we want that from negative 2 to 2. And let's go ahead and type in a plus the slider times our direction vector v. And let's go ahead and run this animation. Actually, let's go ahead and change this color really quickly. Let's change this to this color here. Okay, so let's go ahead and run our animation. And you can see that the point is moving along the portion of the tangent line, and it's actually tracing a line segment. And that's exactly what we're going for. Okay, let me stop this. Currently, the vector that gives the direction of the tangent line is of length, let's see. It's of length 2.24. What I want to use is a unit vector that points in the same direction as v. So I'm going to use u equals, and then I'm going to take v and then divide it by its magnitude. I'm going to type in abs to get the magnitude, and then v itself. And let me change this color to something else. Let's change it to blue. And I'm going to disable v. All right, so now we have our unit vector here. Okay, so now we're ready to draw the tangent segment. So let's go ahead and remove the tangent line as well as some of these other points that we have here. So that, prime. Okay, I think that's good. Here we're going to use the curve command to parameterize the tangent segment. So let's go ahead and type in curve. Then we'll type in our point A plus T times the direction of our tangent line. That's given by G. Let me scroll down a little bit. Divided by the magnitude of that. So that's going to be the direction G. Okay. Then we provide our parameter variable T. And I want this to go from negative 0.5 to 0.5. There we go. Let me change this color to something else. Let me see. Let's change it to red. And I'm also going to increase the line opacity and increase the line thickness to 9. There we go. Of course, you can adjust the length of the tangent segment by changing the parameter values to whatever you want. All right, so now that we know how to parameterize a tangent segment, let's place tangent segments at the points along the curve. So let's go ahead and activate our points. And I'm also going to remove the tangent segment that we created as well as the unit tangent vector. Let me reposition this. We'll do this by using the zip command. So let's type in zip, press enter. Okay, so for the expression, what we're going to use is essentially what we just created over here for our tangent segment. So we're going to type in curve, and then we're going to type in some point, let's call it P, plus T times the direction of some tangent, let's call it F, divided by the magnitude of the direction of f. Our parameter variable is t again, and we're going to have it go from negative 0.5 to 0.5. For our variable, we're going to use that's p, that's going to be our placeholder for our list of points. F is going to be a placeholder for our tangents. So our list of tangents is given by L1. So L1, and let's erase the rest of the stuff here. There we go. Awesome. Let me change this color to something else. Let's see. Let's change it to, let's just use red. Okay. Let's increase the line thickness so we can see it a little bit better. All right, so here we have our mini tangents along the parabola. Using the ideas discussed in this video, I invite you to construct an animation of a tangent segment moving along the curve. All right, so that should do it for today. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.